All right. Hopefully everybody can hear me. I know it's not time yet. We've got like 30 seconds, 40 seconds till 3 o'clock. It's been a long day today. Hope everybody can see me. You can hear me. I see the microphone thing moving, so I know the microphone's working. You need to talk a little bit louder. Hello, hello, hello. Let me click on that microphone thing. See if I can. Oh, that just turns that off. Okay. So it gets to 3 o'clock. So I'm sure. I see one person's here. Awesome. Awesome. I'm glad. Good to see you here. I'm glad you made time to be here. Mr. Roberto, what's going on, brother? Another day. Checking in with everybody, making sure that everybody's ready to go, making sure that everybody's okay. With this thing going on all over the world, make sure everybody's safe and sound in their homes, okay? Taking the proper precautions. All right, I'm here stuck. I guess it's a good thing. I'm gonna look at the positive side of this because now I got nowhere else to go. So I'm working on, because I've been getting a lot of emails and questions on LinkedIn about the, I'm good. Thank you for asking. I hope you're good as well. I'm here now just creating courses for both globed.net, the actual self-paced courses, and also doing stuff for Udemy, all right, which is going to be two totally different, same course, but two totally different ways, because we all know Udemy limits me to 20 minutes, so that's going to be, that's Udemy. You'll be able to take it. You can purchase it. Once it's done and over with and it's processed, it's published in the marketplace, you'll be able to go through it and get certified. On globed.net, I'm going to give you a lot more stuff than you need, old stuff, new stuff, everyday stuff. Okay, so it's, I guess it's out of the negative things that are going on in the world today, I'm looking at the positive side of this by saying, okay, well, I'm stuck. Instead of sitting down watching Netflix all day, all right, or Hulu, or because they took away my PS4, and I'm pissed off about that. All right, PS4 view or P view or something called, I don't know, my stepdaughter's the one who knows about that. Instead of doing that, I'm concentrating more on creating the courses. It's taking a little bit because I am going through each individual chapter with a fine tooth comb. And that's why the boot camp that's coming out this Saturday is going to come out first. Before the course. Usually that's not the case. Usually the course comes out, then I start doing boot camps. Well, now it's going to be different. Now the boot camp's going to come out, and then the course will come out. And maybe it'll come out at the same time as I'm doing the boot camp. So it's just because as I go through the book, I laugh. I'm using the Cisco Press book. I'm not making fun of the Cisco Press, guys. I'm not making fun of it. It's just the terminology, is the configurations, things that I've been doing forever. I'll give you an example. Creating username and passwords. I've been doing that for I don't know how long. All right. Now it popped up in the certification. And they're just doing things that I'm like, what is going on? Okay. Taib, I don't want to mess up your name, man. Taib, I think it is. Hello. I don't know. You wrote something there. I don't know what that means. Okay. But welcome aboard anyway. But yeah, it's going through the book, which is cool because now I have all the time in the world. I'm going through the book and things that I'm like, what is this? What is this? I've done this. I've done that. I've done this. It's like a, it's like, okay. So I see myself going to Google saying, what does this word mean? I see myself going all over the place saying, oh, wow. It's all these things that are going on in there that I want to make sure that I have all the information for you guys for not only the boot camp, but for the courses themselves. All right. So that's why the course is taking a little bit. But man, when this course comes out, yeah, you're going to be laughing. Hey, what's up? What's up? Good day to you, too. You're going to be laughing big time. You're going to be laughing big time because, like I said before, I'm just having fun with this particular course. It's not difficult, all right? Just so you know, And to be, I'm going to be honest with you. I mean, I don't lie to anybody. While in the command prompt, and I'm actually, you know, going through things, you know, verifying and all that, there's Python right in the command prompt. I said, really? And that type didn't help, because there's certain commands that they want you to know for the switching part of it that Packet Tracer doesn't have. So I put it in my presentation, whatever, and give you the definition of what you should be seeing. All right. But I saw, I put attempt in help in the Packet Tracer, and it said Python. And I go, Python. So I typed Python, and a Python prompt came up. I'm like, oh, wow, they have that in the Packet Tracer. Cool. So now you know that Python is in the latest and greatest Packet Tracer. So you can practice it if you haven't downloaded, because I actually downloaded Python. All right, because it's for free. So, but you have it in the Packet Tracer. That's awesome. All right, so now you know. So you don't have to be scared or anything like that. Just again, like I said before, just know a little bit. But yeah, so I want to know where everybody's at. So you have me live now, all right, to just answer the questions from the email. Yes, I'm creating a course for Udemy. Volume one, okay, I'm doing volume one now. That's going to be a course in itself. Volume two will be a course in itself. Will be two separate courses, volume one and volume two. The reason I'm doing that, because I'm putting so much information in there that I just want you to focus on one, get all that done, know it, and then go to the second one. Okay, because Udemy sells it for 10 bucks anyway, so not a big deal. And then GlobeEd, I'm also doing courses for those as well. But that's going to be one complete course. One complete course. Volume one and volume two is going to be on one complete course. Again, you're going to have bonus, which you can't, I'm not doing in Udemy. On GlobeEd, I'm doing bonus because I'm putting all the old stuff in there as well, because I still think you need to know EHRP. I still think you need to know RIP. You need to know about PBX routing protocols. I have a question about router when it comes to default gateway. I had an error always. Well, the default gateway, I mean, is basically just that. I mean, it's your computer. Let's say your computer, right? You have your switch, and then you have your router. The interface facing the switch is your default gateway. That would be the IP address you would put on your computer as the default gateway. Got my CCNA Feb 21st. All right. With the help of you. Oh, okay. Awesome. Course Labs. Really enjoyed talking with you. Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome. What am I got? I got a little update there. There you go. Congratulations. Congratulations. I'm glad. I'm glad. I'm glad. Now you got 3 years to get your CCNP. Roberto, do you already know when the Udemy and GlobeEd courses are going to be available? Man, I'm creating it. I'm going as fast as I can. But again, I'm really going through these chapters, looking, because I know the verbiage is whatever. They're putting things that they've never put in there before. So I got to make sure that I put things in the course that you need to know. So that's why it's taking me slightly a little bit longer. But I think by the time I'm done with the boot camp for volume one, I think either the GlobeEd course will probably be done, and volume one will probably be done by that time. So give me a little month or so, and I should be done with one or the other, okay? Because I'm really going through a fine-tooth comb with this. What's the one? Stay healthy. No, definitely. Listen, guys, I'm not a doctor. I'm not a politician. I'm a network engineer. I'm an educator. Educate yourself. Go out there. Find the information. Just take precautions. All right? Don't be silly. I mean, the things that we got to do, our parents have been telling us to do all our life. Wash your hands. You know, brush your teeth. You know, don't sneeze in people's faces. That's not a nice thing. I'm still going to the gym every morning. Still going. Got my Lysol with me. But I'm still pumping iron. I don't care. I'm still wiping everything down. I'm still going to the gym. All right, I already got everything I need. I'm just not going to get silly with it. I'm going to take the precautions, but just be safe and make sure you have everything you need. I said to you back in October. Awesome. The Udemy course really helped me out. I'm glad. That was awesome. That's awesome. That's awesome. Okay. Definitely, that's what I'm here for. People think otherwise. The other day I was called so many bad words, so many bad names. Why? Why are people calling me bad names? I'm here to help. That's all I'm doing. I'm here. I mean, and if you guys want to see things, oh, by the way, from my last live, somebody said that, hey, they actually they were connecting using layer 3 switches to USB to USB, meaning I meant USB, USB. I didn't mean an adapter that goes from the USB port in the back of the computer to a DB9, all right, to then an RJ45 port. Not that little connector thing. No, no, no. I mean an actual mini USB to a mini USB thing, because the packet tracer does not support that. All the way from the UK, studying CCNA, currently configuring VTP and VLANs. Thanks for, okay. Any word on the new continuing education program? No, I haven't heard anything about that. I really haven't. I think some guy told me about it. I really didn't pay attention much to it. Screw the haters last. Damn right I do. I appreciate you being here. Thank you. Thank you. No problem. As far as from the UK currently configuring VTP, okay. In the book, all right, it was funny because I was just reading that today. In the book, and I've heard it before, but since I'm going through it again, they want you to turn off. They tell you, we turned off VTP during this lap. They turn off VTP. They even say that CCNP, VTP is turned off too. Virtual trunking protocol is important, okay? And they even said, I had to read a statement twice when I did this video today. They said, we're only doing VLANs on access, on a access switch. What? An access layer switch. What? I got confused. Okay. So I guess they're only putting VLANs on the access layer. All right. And you don't need to run. And they're telling me that by creating VLANs, or they're telling you that by creating VLANs, you're going to minimize processor overhead because of spanning tree. You'll be, you know, reduce spanning tree for some reason. I'm like, okay. All right. So there's, be careful with the VTP, go through VTP, study VTP, know VTP, know what it does. They may ask you questions on it, but in the book, Cisco Press book, they said they turned off VTP. Okay. I won. What? You, what am I shirt? What? Oh, what does my shirt say? Shredder Jim. Shredder Jim. Can teach, but it's up to us. Of course. Okay, I see some words I don't understand. Oh, hey, what's up? Ramath, I think I said it correctly. What's up, what's up? Hey, Laz, how do you value continuing education credits versus taking new certs? Listen, this is the second time somebody's asking me that. People have been asking me that. I didn't really know you can do that, all right? I'm going to be completely honest. I mean, if I can take continuing education credits in my job, I guess, so I don't have to take new certs, if that's allowable, that's cool. But also remember that in CCNP, when you're in CCNP, you're going to learn new things that you didn't know in the CCNA. So if this is just going to keep your CCNA alive, that's one thing. But, you know, you want to learn more advanced techniques. So when you get into the CCNP, things are going to get a lot more difficult, a lot more detailed. So if you want to stop at the CCNP level and get all those different designations, you know, well, you have to get at least one. But you get the rest of them, that's understandable. You got to choose which way you want to go. Continuing education credit, continuing education units are things that people take that go to college. Like somebody took their master's back in the 70s, that, you know, or 60s or the 20s. I mean, I don't know. They were using vacuum tubes or whatever. I can see them taking continuing education units so they can try and keep up with today's technology. Not that they can, but they try. All right, because I've taught many people with PhDs and masters and all sorts of things. And they have no freaking clue on the new CCNA. Not to talk bad about them. It's just that's not their thing, or they haven't kept up with it. Because certifications go into major details, and that's what's so important. That's why certifications are up here now. You get a bachelor's in networking, you're here. You get a CCNA, you're up here. Okay, because it goes into more detail than any bachelor's program. Because your first 2 years in college is bullshit anyway. You're gonna learn what, art? I hated that. Okay, you learn psychology. Really? Are you going to psychoanalyze the router? Well, I believe the router is acting this way due to... No, you're not going to do that, okay? You better know your damn commands. You better know how to configure things that you need to configure. Okay? So let me get myself better in the picture. Right here, so you can see my wonderful bald spot. Okay, there. You see my beard? Cool, cool. All right. So yeah, CEUs. I mean, if you want to just take CEUs to maintain your job, that's one thing. But always try to strive to get higher and different certifications. I just took the CCNA class, but I didn't learn much. The progression wasn't clear on a lot of things. Do you recommend any YouTube videos? You can go to my website, man. You got me, all right, the networking doctors, okay? The Networking Doctors on YouTube. Go there, subscribe, hit the bell, all that good stuff. All right. And I have a whole bunch of videos, HSRP, BGP, redistribution within different autonomous systems, EIGRP, static routes, IP subnetting, VLSM, route summarization. I got all of that, all of that. And I'm sure other instructors out there got it. All you got to do is just, you know, if you go to my YouTube channel, you'll see it. But you can just go on YouTube and type subnetting. Now, I do subnetting in a special way. Remember, 30 seconds or less. If you start doing that 2N minus 2 and the higher order bits and the lower order bits and, you know, X to the third times pi and all this other crap, you don't have time for that to do that in the test, okay? You just need to learn, hey, that's the math. This is how many bits are on. The bits to the left is how I increment. Increment, one less is my broadcast, which is in between is my range. Done. That's it, okay? You got 10 fingers, an octet is 8 bits. Hey, Les, gracias for sharing your knowledge. No problem. Anytime, brother. I am not going to take the CCNA 200-301. I don't want to. I don't need to. No. I got the books. I'm going to give you guys the knowledge. Once you take the CCNA 231 and you pass it, come back to me. I mean, hey, Les, this is what I saw. Not that I want to give everybody the answers, but that way I can streamline my course even more. So when I do my boot camps, focus on this, people. Focus on this. But me take the CCNA ever again? Hell no. All right. Hey, Les. Les, I configured NAT and already verified my connectivity from PC web browser to server. But when I type show IP NAT translation, it's blank. If it's blank, check your interfaces, your IP NAT inside, IP NAT outside. All right. That could be an issue right there. Make sure you're pointing to the correct access list. Your pool is case sensitive, so make sure you're pointing to the right pool. Those are things that you will look at. All right, I can figure. Okay, is there something? What's wrong? No, I'm good. It's all good, man. Kenji, what's up, dog? It's all good, man. It's all good. Hello, sir. I plan to get my CCNP Encore Enterprise Network Design. My idea is to understand anything from a more global perspective. What do you think? I think that's awesome. I think that's awesome because there's different branches in IT. And people do need to get people need to hire individuals that have a broader perspective on how the network should be designed. And learning the design and what each device does is extremely important. Designing, project management, all these different things, yes, it's on demand, okay? People want people like this. And even as a network engineer, if you're down in the trenches, you need to understand what each device does and how the network is going to be designed. But you definitely need an individual that's going to know all this. And that person can actually design the network properly. Because people are just buying switches at Best Buy and just plugging things in and routers, and they have no idea what they're doing. So definitely doing that, I think that's awesome. That's a hell of a way to go. Can you take the new CCNA in a month? Well, how have you been studying? All right, it's a lot of pages. It's a lot of stuff. All right, especially for volunteers, my biggest fear for everybody because it has the programming in it and it has the APIC and all that silliness. But volume one, volume two, you got to take a little time on. So I hope you've been studying for a while. Would you recommend to buy some of the new CCNA books and start studying right away or wait for your courses? No. Get your books and start studying now. You know why? That way you can question my courses. That way you can question me in the boot camps. Get your books now, okay? Why wouldn't you? Get your books, see what the book states. And if you're in a boot camp, when he says, last, yeah, but in the book it states this. Last, that's what I would do when I was going to school. You get your books. I already know everything in the book before I went into the classroom. I read the book already. All right, or I seen a video on it already. Because I used to go to this website that would give you like 5 back then. Okay, don't laugh. All right, 5 CDs. All right. And in those 5 CDs, it would be the entire course. Like NetWare. I learned NetWare in those CDs. When I went to my network class, I knew how to configure NetWare. The teacher thought I worked in IT for NetWare. Okay, because I was ready. And then when he would put things on there, I wouldn't. Don't do this. Don't, how do you say that? Don't test your teacher. Don't, you know, you can say things, hey, you know, on this page, it says this. Is this correct? Can you elaborate on that? Don't say, oh, you're wrong, Laz. You're wrong. Look what it says here. It says this, this, and this. Because that's not the correct way of saying it. All right. But, you know, definitely you can call me out on it. Say, hey, Laz, man, but in this routing protocol, it states AY, you know, ABC. And we're like, okay, well, this is the reason why it's telling you ABC. If I know my stuff, I should tell you why. All right. There is no more CCNA specialities. No, there is not. No, there's one CCNA, only one. Okay, there's CCNP and then some designations there. But there is no CCNA specialities at all. It's one CCNA, all inclusive. Okay, so that's why if you're going to study for that, be ready for that. But I'm telling you, it's not as scary as you think. From Cali, Colombia. Un trabajo disponible también en español. Magnífico. Un día yo voy a hacer una clase en español también. For those of you that don't speak Spanish, I said that one day I will have the courage. I didn't say that in Spanish, but I will have the courage to do it in Spanish. And that messed up. I'm Cuban, and I don't want to do it in Spanish. What's up, Asval? Oh, no. Afzal. Okay. Do CCNA and then CCNP security, you can take CompTIA Security Plus as a primer. Yeah, definitely. I suggest everybody should have their Security Plus. Get that DOD letter, definitely. And then go on from there. Go on from there. Get your CCNP core, then go do, you know, security for CCNP. You know, definitely, definitely go for it. Go for it. Go for it. Big time. CCNP security. Yes, yes. Exam scheduled for April 22nd. Lovely, lovely. I haven't read volume 2 yet, but the new programming API stuff scares me. Don't let it scare you. Don't let it scare you. It's new. It's challenging a little bit. It's not that bad. I've done a little bit of it already. It's pretty simple to understand. It's not going to be a major deal. Listen, do you think that honestly going to make you? You can't. It's look, JSON. Let me see. Ansible, Python, JSON, Chef, Puppet, and REST for all these 8 different APIs. You can't learn all those 6 freaking languages in a month or 2 months or 3 months. You just can't. All right. I mean, they're easy to learn and understand, but you know, what's the squiggly line for? Those little curly brackets, you know, the curly brackets, you can use the parentheses, you can use the quotes. You need to understand all these different things, but you're not going to be doing major stuff. You're not going to be doing, I keep getting updates, damn it. Major stuff. Okay. So don't leave us, girl. You're a little confused. What are you confused of, Kenji? Talk to me. Talk to me, Kenji. Christopher, what's up? Just came in, was busy. Hey, man, it's been a busy day for me too, even though I'm home, but I've been trying to do the course. Everybody's asking me about the course. I'm trying to get it out as quick as I can. Quick question. How come your courses in Udemy are way cheaper than on your website? I have no control over that. Udemy, I can put a price in Udemy, and then Udemy always discounts everything at 10 bucks. That's, Udemy gives you a limit. Udemy limits you how much you can charge for your course. In GlobeEd, I have the freedom. Well, that's why in GlobeEd, I'm going to give you 200 more times the information that I will in Udemy. In Udemy, I'll give you what you need to pass for sure. Okay? For sure. But in GlobeEd, I'm going to give you a lot more stuff beyond the certification. So that's just the way it is. Okay? That's just the way it is. But Udemy controls you. Udemy controls you. Controls your time limit, 20 minutes per lecture. That's it. You know what I mean? You got to beg and plead just to get any more minutes. In GlobeEd, I have an hour lecture in GlobeEd. 30 minutes, 40 minutes, 50 minutes. It don't matter. Okay? I have freedom in GlobeEd. I got Tech Plus. Awesome. Need to go deep into networking, but unsure if to go. Of course you can go to CCNA, man. Why would you want to get your Network Plus? That wouldn't even make sense. It's CCNA. If you're a CCNA, somebody actually interviewed one of my students that had their CCNA, says, do you have your Network Plus? Do you have your A Plus? And he's like, what? He went off on them. He actually went out. He so you know who my instructor is? Apparently somehow he knew me. He goes, yo, okay. You know, you just want me to come to your school. I'm here to apply for a job. I have my CCNA. How can you tell me that if I got my CCNA, I don't know how to network? Seriously? Seriously. Okay? So you can do CCNA. Don't worry about that. Okay? You're now allowed to skip. Yes, you are. You're allowed to skip the CCNA altogether. if you know the material, no, not well, well, that's a big if, then you're allowed to take, you're allowed to take the CCNP straight away. Yeah, you're allowed to take the CCNP. You can bypass the CCNA all day, every day. Go for it. Go for it. I dare you. All right. I'm telling you right now, it's not that it's going to be that difficult. It's the terminology and the way that they confirm. Like I said before, I've said it before in all my live interviews, on my lives and on my videos. Just another example, OSPF, which is the main thing. You don't configure it using network commands. You configure it under the interface. Not a big deal, easier for you. But everybody's used to doing network commands. But now, if you do that in the new CCNA, you're wrong. You see what I mean? So that's what you got to understand. Be careful, because CCNP is going to get a lot deeper into programming languages and into the software design network stuff as well. It seems to me like most of the topics on the 200.31 volume is a repetition. It is very repetitive. It is very repetitive. They just changed the terminology. They phrased it a different way and put things in there, because we got to remember this. When you go take a test, they made a new brand new book out of this that you have to purchase. So they made a new book and they're making you actually go to the website to register the book, because they've been wanting you to do this every time so you can get additional information. I guarantee you that they're going to ask you questions. They were asking these people at the end when I was doing November, December friggin' boot camps, you know, and 8-hour crash courses. They were giving them questions that were in the dark, deepest corners of the book. Okay, they weren't even in the book. They could have been on their website, because it's all fair. If it's in the book, it can be in the test. But now they got things that you're like, what? What is this doing here? I'm not an electrician. I told you this already about the voltage on your TCP wiring. They talk about the voltage that makes a complete circuit. What the hell? Tone it, okay? Test the cable. Oh, we're good. 8 lights, we're good, full house, you know, but they're getting crazy. That's why you need to get the new books. That's why you need to go over the new stuff, because of the terminology and the configuration change. Remember, they took out supposedly EHRP, but you'll be getting EHRP questions. They stopped VTP. They want you to turn it off, but they're still going to ask you questions about it. Okay, but it's all random, different questions that they never asked before. So be very careful. Volume 2 is hard. Parsons, it should be done in studying automated scripting, Python, etc. When are you going to get ready for your Volume 2 course, and would you sell it? No, I'm doing Volume 2 now on GlobeEd. Of course I'm going to put that on there. Volume 2 will have the scripting and all that stuff in there. And when I do my boot camp for Volume 2, I will have the scripting on there as well. Okay, I'm gonna have everything. The only thing I don't have, is the Cisco DNA. I'm not gonna have the Cisco DNA on there. I'm not gonna pay for that. Okay, but we'll talk about it. What you really need to understand. I mean, they want you to understand the Cisco DNA. They do a good job in Volume 2 of explaining the APIC controller. The North API versus the South API, the control plane, the data plane, all that stuff. They do a very good job with that in Volume 2. Definitely, they do a good job with that. But you'll see that they'll tell you that came out when this certification came out, and really it's obsolete anyway. They want you to know the Cisco DNA. And the only way to know the Cisco DNA, go to cisco.com, research the Cisco DNA. You'll see that a bunch of videos on that, and you can see, and they'll actually make you create a solution, and they'll tell you the hardware and software and stuff that you need. You got to play with it. If you don't play with the Cisco DNA, you're not going to learn it. But there's videos that come out. So just go to Cisco. Go to cisco.com, look for Cisco DNA, and they'll have a ton of friggin' videos in there for you to watch. New CCNA also has APIs in YAML, yes. And RESTConf, yes. RESTConf is on there as well. They don't do a bad explanation on there, and definitely I will give you a very good explanation on that as well. Very simple, very straight to the point, all right? And based on other instructors that have taken the certification, one said they had some simulations. One guy said that he never had any simulations whatsoever. One guy said that it wasn't so bad. It was basically what the book said. Other one said that it was the most hardest test he's ever had taken. He's a CCIE, all right, and has ever taken. It was tough, all right? So, I mean, I don't know. Everybody has a different experience. Me, I am not taking it. I can tell you that right now. I am not taking CCNA ever again in my life. All right. Will I renew? Will I do a CCMP? Okay, I'll do that. Okay. Will I do the CCIE? Definitely. Okay. I will do other certifications. Okay. I will do, let's say, another security plus. I will now go to Microsoft and find a role-based access or a role-based certification that I feel like, because next year I'm going to my big network engineering course. That's going to be like 3 to 4 months. All right. That's going to include a bunch of stuff. And they're one of them, maybe Microsoft. That's so we can get into it. No, yeah. Lab, all the way live. Okay. You need to understand why you're doing it though. Just don't do lab. Just don't memorize commands. Know what these commands are doing and why are you doing it and why are you doing it in this position. That's why that individual that said that they're going for their design, that's awesome. That is awesome. You need to understand, are you doing a tier 2 or a tier 3? What type of switches are you using? Is everybody using 9,000 switches, by the way? No. Okay. 2960 switches are end of life, but they have them in the book, CCNA. But it's XR. It's still end of life. Laz, GNS3 or even G? Me, even G. I used GNS3 in the past. They're awesome. They're great. If you go to David Bombal, he's like the man in GNS3. So he'll tell you exactly how to install it and work with it. I personally, even G is a low curve. You know, very easy to do. Very, you know, to create stuff, as long as you have the real iOS. Remember, you need the iOS for the router and you need the iOS for the switch. Okay, so you need to get it with Virl. But even G is much easier to play with than, for me, than GNS3. I create DNS with a public address. I can access it already through the web PC, a private address. But when I type show IP net transmission spike, the pool is right. The access list is right. So you're pointing to the right access list. You're pointing to the right pool. What about your internal interfaces? IPNet inside, IPNet outside. Do you check that? Make sure that that's correct because that's usually the issue. All right. But if you're not saying show IPNet translation, then it's not doing any translation. And if it's not doing any translation, if you're actually going online, that's interesting that you're not getting anything because it is translating because you can't get online with a private IP. Right? You're going to get online with a public IP. So it has to translate from that private to that public. Unless you're using some sort of third-party software that I'm not aware of. All right? But check your interfaces. See if your private is your private and your public is your public. All right? And if you are pointing to the proper pool and you have the proper IP address, public IP address in your pool, or are you using the exit interface as your in your pool? Not in your pool. In the first line, damn it. Oh, yeah, your pool and your first line. Do I have to renew the CCNA after 3 years? I'm sorry, I'm wearing my glasses. I got to look at least having passed a exam, my first attempt, it was prerequisite. No, yeah, you still got to pass a CCNA. If it's been longer than 3 years, you got to redo. You got to renew it. You got to renew your CCNA. It's expired. It's only wireless, but I feel like only one is 30% new material. No, You're right. The part one is, you know, that I'm sticking my whole entire wireless course at the end for you guys. But yeah, the first part is very, very simple. Very simple. If you get my CSET, let's say, or my ICND courses, or if you already have them, you can probably get away with a lot of things for the new test. But again, I urge on the side of caution. Be careful because it's terminology that is going to screw you over because they're calling things different names. Okay, and you saw that stupid video that I put up there. I thought it was going to be funny. It's not funny. On spurious DHCP, rogue DHCP. Okay, really? Okay, so terminology is what's going to kill you, and the way to configure things is what's going to kill you. So that is the only thing that I'm really concerned about when it comes to, like he said, 30% is only new stuff. The other 70% is the old stuff, but the old stuff done a new way. So careful. That's why I'm confused, but that, by the way, but thanks. Okay. Yeah, that's all. Listen, when you're taking the test, forget about what, some of you are already in IT anyway. Okay. Forget about what you do at work. And forget about the old test, all right? Like, I know that stuff. So I look at the book. I'm like, oh my God, really? All right. So I'll just do a new test, make fun of it. And that's it. You know what I mean? That's what I do. That's why I'm taking long to do it. All right. But at GlobeEd, trust me, you're going to have all the new information. Udemy, just the new stuff. Just so you can pass your new CCNA. That's it. Okay. But GlobeEd, way more, way more. I meant to say you get the new CCNA. Oh, by default. Yeah. If you're already CCNA certified, yeah, you're grandfathered in. You're grandfathered in. You don't have to renew that one. You just go straight for your CCNP. Okay. Just study your CCNP very well, please. Very well. Because there are changes. Okay. So just study that. If you're already grandfathered in, yeah, hell, don't take that again. Got my name CCNA in September, then landed my first IT network job. Joy and favorite. Congratulations, Joshua. Congratulations to you, sir. Congratulations. Definitely, definitely, definitely. But if you're already CCNA certified, don't take your CCNA again, because you get grandfathered in. You get your little ribbon, whatever, certificate, whatever they give you. Okay? Badge of honor, right? So just keep that. Don't worry about that. But then study for your CCNP. But study, I mean, like I'm giving a boot camp in September. No. Is it? I think it's August 22nd. August 22nd to September something. I don't remember. Look, go to GlobeEd.net and look it up. I'm doing the CCNP/CCIE. What is it? 300-41 or 350-41. I'm doing that one. Go to GlobeEd.net and take a look at it. So you have your CCNP and your CCIE written. Okay. You'll have that one under your belt. Okay. Because I'm giving that course. That's going to be a long course. You're going to be with me for a long time, but you're going to get a lot of information. Okay. So if you want to do that, that's fine. Got my CCIE in September. Okay. All right. I appreciate you cut the crap out. Love GlobeEd courses of yours. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much. That's what I'm trying to do. Is your Udemy courses updated for the latest exam version? Okay. Let me explain something about Udemy again. Udemy used to allow us to put our courses up and pre-sell them as we do them, right? They don't allow that anymore. So they got to wait till I'm done with the course, publish it, they look at it, they say it's cool, then they'll put it in the marketplace. So once I'm done with volume one, I'm publishing it. So at least you guys have that one. And then I'll start on volume two, okay? So I can get it done. I'm trying to do it as fast as I can. I'm just going through every little terminology change that they've done and configurations. And I'm trying to work on both sides, Udemy and GlobeEd, to get them out, okay? But don't let that stop you. Get either the Cisco Press, and you always heard me say, Todd Lamley, he does have CCNA, and he does have CCNP. So get his books. Look for him as well. Why do I choose Todd Lamley? Because Todd Lamley is easy to read, easy to do. If you're just new and you're studying, whatever. Or even if you've been around for a while, he's just fun to read. Okay? I love his books. I use Cisco Press just to make it more whatever. But again, I read it, but then I simplify for everybody else. That's what I try to do. I don't try to give you all their BS terminology that they use. Let me get this straight. I passed the 200-125. Does that mean that I get the new... If your 200-125 did not expire, you are now grandfathered in. Log into your Cisco account, go look at your certification, and you should have your little badge in there or whatever, or contact Cisco and let them know. If it did not expire, you should be grandfathered in. You should not have to take the new test. No. Okay. Where do I get those from? Where do you get what from? Where do you get what from, Omar? That was on January 27th. All right, dude, then you're good. You're straight. You should have it. James, you're good. Omar, where do I get what? Todd's books. Amazon, bro. Where else? Where does everybody get all their stuff? Amazon. Go to Amazon. All right. Or you can go to Todd Lamley's website himself. I think it's Lamley.com. All right, my wife is on here. She's monitoring, so she'll probably put in the link or something. All right, but it's Lamley.com. Todd Lemley's books are easier reading than Wendell Odom, for sure, 100%. That's not to say Odom's books aren't the best, just Todd's books are easier to read. Exactly. I agree with you 100% there, Dave. Any CCMP study material suggestions? Again, same people, same people. Todd or Cisco Press, I'll tell you Todd first. Okay, there my wife put information for Todd, I think. The Udemy courses are not the same as, yeah, they're not the same as Globe Ed. But yeah, if I tell you, there's two people you should just look at as far as books. Todd or Cisco Press. That's it. I did my CCNA. I'm not doing another one. I might do another one. I don't know. Next year or something. I may do it. It's taking me long to do it's taking me longer than I should. I'm kind of upset at myself, actually. But I'm just going through the thing with a fine tooth comb to make sure I give you all the information you need. You know, all the stupid little terminology that they want. And I'll tell you, hey, this is for test purposes only. Right there on the course, I'll tell you. You know what I mean? But this is what you need to know. All right. And then that's it. I'm not gonna BS you around. All right. If you pass the old CCNA within the past 3 years before February 23rd, 2020, you're grandfathered in. Oh, that's right. You're talking to somebody else. Sorry. Yeah, you're grandfathered in. You're good. You're good. Yeah, if you already have the CCNA and you're grandfathered in, for God's sake, don't take the same thing again. No. Go for your CCMP. Okay. Go for it. Do it to it. All right. Do it to it. Study your butt off. You Cisco Press, you Todd's, whichever one you think you feel is easier to read for you, wherever you feel comfortable, and just go for it. Just go for it. My boot camp is not coming out for the CCMP, but again, it's going to be the CCMP / CCIE. I think it's 350-401. And not until September. Yeah, as I'm always said, Amazon. If all my search expired last year, then you're out of gas, bro. Do I need to subscribe to Cisco again? Or is the old Cisco account? No, the old Cisco account is still valid. It's still valid. You only get one Cisco account. All you got to do is just retake the CCNA and you're good to go. If all your Cisco certs expire, just go ahead and take the CCNA again. It'll give you the same account. You don't have to renew your account. It'll be the same one. If all my certs, okay, same question. All right, but that's it. Listen. Unfortunately, I'm trying to make a positive thing out of a negative. Like I said earlier when we started, all this stuff that's going on is unfortunate. I'm hoping that all you guys are safe and sound and you're all prepared, okay? But don't go crazy. Don't go insane, okay? Just take the proper precautions. Like I said, I'm still going to the gym. I'm still working out. My gym hasn't closed. Okay, I got my Lysol in my gym bag. I'm wiping everything down. Be safe. But now, since people are staying home, they don't let you go to work, all this other stuff. See, I got no problems because my work is online, so I got no issues. But the whole thing is, take precautions. That's all. Take precautions. Don't sneeze on nobody. Don't bite nobody. Don't be kissing anybody at the club. Okay? Clubs are closing anyway. I think they closed the movie theater all across the world. Just be safe. Okay, just say, wash your hands, all that good stuff. I mean, do you cover CCMP courses? Yes, I do. And I will be putting out my CCMP bootcamp though before I put out the CCMP course. I'll tell you that right now. The CCMP, the one that I'm doing, the one that I'm going to do is that CCMP Enterprise, the CCMP / CCIE one. All right, you can find that on Amazon.com. It's one book. I don't have it near me. It's somewhere. Okay, but that's the one that I'm going to teach. I think it's 350-401, but look it up on Amazon, CCMP, routing and switching, whatever. See, and it'll come up CCMP/CCIE. That's the one I'm doing. Tell on Amazon, CCNA 200. Yeah, okay, she's putting stuff up. My wife is putting stuff up. So yeah, he has that. So if you find Todd easier, then do it to it. But again, listen, thing that they've divided up, so they're just dividing things up so crazy. That's why the book is so friggin' whatever. They're short chapters, to be honest with you, especially in volume one. And I don't know why there's so many, but they do have, the IPv4. Go to the networkingdoctors.com. Go to the, what is it? My God, I forgot. Products, there you go. Products tab. I don't handle that. So the products tab, and you have my PDF book for IP addressing. It's $4. Okay. So you can download it. So you can sub now or go to YouTube. If you don't want to get pay $4, which is less than a Happy Meal, but go ahead. If you don't want to pay the $4 for the book, then go to my YouTube video and see my submitting videos. Okay. You got them all there. Thank you for your time. The only reason I passed the exam is because of your, well, thank you. Thank you. I watched on Udemy and that helped me pass. Oh, you're welcome. Thank you, James. I appreciate that, brother. Thank you so much. You know, but like I said, I'm here to help. And I tell everybody, listen, I think you can see my picture on here. I got the Panama hat on. Okay. If you guys subscribe to LinkedIn, thanks, brother. Thanks, Anthony. If you guys subscribe to, you know, Laz on LinkedIn, but it's got to be, I have three profiles. It can't be the one with the yellow shirt. It's got to be the one with the Panama hat. Okay. And that's the main one I have on my phone. You can always message me there and I can answer you right away because it's on my phone. I don't got to log into any platform. I don't got to log into any email. It's right there on my phone. So I can just answer you real quick. So look me up on LinkedIn. I have a hard copy of your IP book. Awesome. That I got from Amazon. It told me I got a ton. Awesome. Awesome. Roughly how long should it take to complete the new CCNA Volume 1? What in the only part that's missing in Globet is the wireless, I think, that I got put in there. I started, but didn't finish it. So I started putting some Volume 2, so you know I'm doing Volume 2. So I just got to finish the wireless for Volume 1, and that should be good to go. For Udemy Volume 1, I say I'll be done just to give me time because I'm doing a million things at once. Remember, guys, I have 300,000 plus students worldwide. They're constantly emailing me and asking me questions and stuff like that. Not to make an excuse. All right. But I mean, due to this stuff that's happening, I guess I'll be more freed up and I'm just stuck inside my house. So I'll be working a lot more and I'll be trying to get this done a lot quicker. But no, I say no more than 30 days, man. Give me 30 days to do at least Udemy Volume 1 to get that done. All right, and to finish it up on Globet for wireless, because I got to make sure, I just want to make sure I get all the terminology correct. I don't want to get dinged by somebody telling me, hey, Laz, you forgot this. I'm like, oh, damn it. You know what I mean? So I don't want that to happen. You know what I mean? I mean, I can always update it, but I don't want that to happen. I want to make sure you get all the stuff that you need or require when you take that test. Thank you so much, Dave. I appreciate that, brother. Roughly how? Okay, you already said that. But yeah, that's why it's taking me long, because I'm just trying to make sure you get it right. Maybe I'm taking too much time being, you know, too nitpicky, and I should just put things out there. But definitely, that's why I want everybody to join LinkedIn, my Panama thing, so I can have you on my phone. So then I can, if you have a question or doubt, or just say, hey, what's up? You know what I mean? I'm like, oh, hey, you know, I don't care. You know, I'll tell you right now. From, I'd say, because I'm going late now, from 6:45 to about 8:30, I'm at the gym. At the gym, I don't answer my phone. I got to tell you now, I do not. I'm in the gym. I'm listening to some hardcore Viking death metal crazy stuff, and then I'm just working out, all right? And then after that, then I start checking my phones and my messages and all that stuff. My wife does look at the email, all right? And my stepdaughter is just editing her butt off. All right, trying to put up the courses as quick as she can as well. As quick as I get it done, she's editing it and trying to put it up. It's going to be different, all right? Not going to see me in front of the camera because I'm trying to just do it quick. All right, desktop record, do this, PowerPoint, boom. All right, put it up, just put a picture, send it up so you guys can have it. Because I'm trying, again, I'm being very nitpicky because I saw what happened in the CCNA 200-125 towards the end. And I think they did it because it was towards the end. They were giving them questions that I'm like, my God, that's in the miscellaneous part of the book that nobody even reads. So I'm making sure that I'm covering all my bases. And I'm telling everybody, if you do have Cisco Press books, even Todd's books, register them online. Cisco Press, Cisco Press books, you go to ciscopress.com/register and register your book using your ISBN. Doesn't cost you anything. You're going to see extra information on there, all right? And then for Todd Lamley, I think it's lamley.com. And you can go ahead and register your book there, I believe. I may be mistaken, but I believe. Okay? But definitely, okay? You can go ahead and do that. I'm reading this, but the terminology is, yeah, it is hard to understand. It is. So that is, it is hard to understand. It really is. And I'm telling you, today I had to read this. I literally had to read one little sentence like five times. I'm like, what? It just didn't make any sense what it was saying, but I made sense of it. Okay. And that's why when I put it in the course, I'm reading it. I'm like, okay, this is what you need to know in this particular lecture. And that's it. All right. And that's all they're going to ask you, because no, you got an extra 30 minutes. What is it now? 2 hours you can take. It used to be 90 minutes. Now it's 2 hours. Okay. So they give me that extra bit for maybe doing a little script, since Python is in the packet tracer. Okay. That's now why now you can, you know, they'll give you that extra 30 minutes, but that's it. It's not, you're creating this major script or anything. Hate to be out of sync. Just join the stream. Oh, that's fine, man. No worries. I joined the NetAcad, my school, this month. Okay. Now we have online classes. Okay. Yeah, obviously I'm trying to be ready for the exam by June. Brother, the NetAcad is great. All right. I've taught NetAcad when I was in the brick and mortar. They're very confusing as hell, though. They're very granular. I hope you have the books. I'm sure you have the books. The way I study, I think I said it last time, I use a lot of highlighting, underlining, you know, take a look at the notes, and just do the labs. If you don't understand, do the labs. Do the labs. The labs will give you that missing understanding. And I swear to God, it will. Do the labs and you'll get the understanding. If you don't understand something, like I said, find me on LinkedIn with the Panama hat and say, hey, I don't get this. Boom. And I can give you a quick answer back where to go. Go to my YouTube channel. I have a whole bunch of information in there as well. Okay. Just look at go to the videos tab and look for and search for a particular video and see if it's in there. Careful though, man. A lot of people have been stealing my stuff and it's like you're going to somebody else's channel then. So just be careful that it's me talking and that it's being my, you see my face or you hear me talking. So be careful where you go. But the NetAcad, they're very granular. The only good thing, that's good, but it's also bad. Because I would say if you pass once, not if, when you pass the Cisco Net Academy, they should hand you your CCNA. Because in the Net Academy, you take chapter tests, you take a midterm test, and you take a final exam. They're hard. If you pass that class, okay, I'll say 80% or 80% or better, they should give you your CCNA. Because the test won't be that hard. That's at least that was my experience when I taught the Net Academy at the brick and mortar. It was harder for the students in the classroom than it was taking the test. The test was a joke. It was easy. You know, if you had a level one, level 10, NetAcad test, 11. CCNA exam, 5. Okay. That's how the difference was. So just so you know. Brendan, what's up, bro? I'm good, man. I'm good. How you been? How you been? Good to see you here, man. Good to see you here. I'm glad you're here. Hope everything is well. Hope you're networking the world already. Okay. I know you went through a whole bunch of stuff. So it's good to hear from you again. It's always good to hear from any of my old students. But I hope you didn't let your CCNA expire, Brandon. And now you got to take the new one, bro. I think you told me you had taken your CCNP already. So your CCNA shouldn't have expired. Hopefully, if it hasn't, make sure look at, go to Cisco. I suggest that everybody go to their account. All right. Go to their account, your Cisco.com account, whatever it is, and take a look at your certs and see what's expired and what's not expired. Because if you're already grandfathered in, you don't need to take the CCNA 200-301. You should have a little badge and telling your certification is good up to this date and all that. All right. And then you can just go straight for your CCNP. But if you're going straight for your CCNP, please get the book. Please study your butt off. Please, you know, get whatever simulator, emulator. If you do CCNP, then definitely you need an emulator, okay? You need an emulator. Either GNS3, either even G, or you can or use, you know, Viral. I call it Viral, all right? Or you're using live equipment. Whatever it takes, all right? The cheapest way that you can get it, that you can do it, that's the way you go. But you need an emulator. Because you have to purchase the actual iOS. which is, I think it's 150 or 200 bucks. You need to purchase the actual iOS for the Switch and the actual iOS for the router that you're going to use. But definitely, you're going to need that. Packet Tracer, yeah, for the CCNA, you can get away with it. Not a big deal. But for CCNP and beyond, no. So definitely, yeah, go to Cisco.com. My wife is putting it on there. Go to Cisco.com and take a look, take a gander, see what's going on. You can check your shirts and badges on Pearson View. Awesome. Okay. Yeah. Yes, it did expire. I have family. Well, if it did, don't worry about it, man. Just take the new test. You'll be fine. Take the new test. If you had the old test, it's not going to be that difficult to take the new test. It really isn't. Because as you read it, you're like, well, I know this. But listen, in the new book, they give you those five or six questions in the front of the test. Do I know this knowledge? And you're looking at it, and you're like, well, what are they saying? And then you look at the answers, and you're like, okay. Because they're asking you these questions that the way they phrase it, you're like, what the hell are they asking me? So, and that's the whole thing with that, okay? But if you go through the new test, again, new terminology, new way to configurations, they turned off VTP, they said, but they still ask you questions. EHRP, they say they're not using it. RIP, they say they're not using it, but they still ask you questions. OSPF, under the interface, not network commands. All right, BGP is still there. MPLS is a little bit more in there. But again, it's no big deal. I think I did a video on this on MPLS. It's not a big deal. I showed everybody how to configure MPLS within OSPF. Okay, so I think I put it out there. I don't know. They're short. Yeah, I think I put it out there on YouTube. I think it's on YouTube, so go check it out. I have bought your and some other old CCNA courses on Udemy. Should I hold off and wait to the latest course? What I have. Listen, man, go over the stuff you know already. If you're going to buy it from Udemy, you got to wait till I'm done with Volume 1. They're not going to put it until I'm done, and I'm trying to haul ass to get that thing done. Okay, so if you want to wait, as you wait, don't be twiddling your thumbs. Read the book, study the old stuff that you have from me to just refresh your memory. Okay, practice some labs, make up your own topology, practice some labs. Okay, so you start getting the hang. Go to my YouTube channel so you can take a look at a bunch of videos, right? All the stuff that I used to do, so you can get back into the swing of things. And then, all right, once my Udemy course is out, if you want to buy it on Udemy. You know what I mean? It's just for the test, though. Just know that. Sorry. It's 10 bucks. It's a happy meal. But you'll pass your cert. GlobeEd, yeah, it's going to be completely different. It's going to be for that. Yeah, you'll pass your certification and then some. Okay? And then some. All right? That's what's going to be the difference. You bought the new books. Brandon, do you have the Cisco Press new books? Brandon? Well, Brandon, if you bought the Cisco Press books, register them on ciscopress.com/register so you can get access to new files, new stuff, okay? All right, so register it, okay? Register those books on cisco.com/register with the ISBN number so you can gain access to further flashcards, videos, more info, okay? Get it, do it, practice, okay? Get me on LinkedIn. Hello, you can message me. Okay, good. Message me. Okay. And remember, this weekend, even though I'm not done with Volume 1 on Udemy, or if I'm not completely done with the Volume 1 or Volume 2 on the GlobeEd, I'm working on it. But that's why I'm doing the bootcamp. That is the sole purpose I'm doing the bootcamp, because that's why it's only weekends only. So during the week, I can work on the courses, right? Both GlobeEd and Udemy. And on the weekend, I'm going to be teaching you guys. Okay? So you got to get you ready. So I'll be getting you ready. All right? You guys will be studying, right? Because I have already stuff up there in GlobeEd. All right? Because you can't see it in Udemy. I have stuff already up on Udemy, but you can't see it. Because not until I finish, they won't publish it. But on GlobeEd, you can. You can see it as I go. Okay? But if you take the boot camp, okay, then you'll be good. Because I think it's six boot camps. Six weekends, I think. Four. It's four weekends. I don't know. Go look at it. I think it's four because it's 48 hours, I think. Yes, 12 times. Yeah, I think it's four weekends. and you'll have me there for 4 weekends. And believe me, you just more than enough than you'll need. Okay, because I'm going to give you everything what you need to know. Again, it's, you know, with the side, what do you call those things? The horses wear, whatever, blinders, whatever, on. So because I'm going to focus you on what you need to know. Okay, like you said, somebody said it here. Well, man, I think only 30% is new on volume one. Volume two is 50%. Exactly. Okay, so it's not that much of a stretch. Okay, so if you do the boot camp, you'll have volume one. And then when I do my second boot camp, which is for volume two, you'll have that. And if you have the courses and you have the boot camp and you have the books, there should be no reason why you shouldn't pass. All right. Now, if you're going to take my boot camp, if you're going to take my boot camp, I swear to you, it better not be a quiet boot camp. It better be a boot camp full of questions. Okay. Yeah, there's the date. 4 weekends, March 21st, Rebel 12. Thank you, Mrs. Diaz. Okay. You better ask me questions. If you have me there live, online, and I'm teaching you a course, why wouldn't you ask me questions? Oh, you've been in Huno Lab with two Cisco 921s. So second K9s and two Cisco switches. Cisco. All right, awesome, dude. Awesome. Do it to it. Okay, do it to it. All right, if you can use live equipment, that's the best thing you can do. Before taking the BC, what the hell is a BC? What is BC? I don't know. What's BC? Oh, the boot camp. Okay. Sorry. You haven't had any experience. Because I'm going to teach you from scratch. That's the beauty of it. Okay. Let me ask you, James. Are you in IT? Yes or no? That's all I need to know. Yes or no? Yes. Okay. If you're in IT, then you're good. Don't worry about it. You're good. Okay. It's not like I got to tell the same story to everybody. I've taught long time ago. Okay. I think this was the CCNA 200-120. Okay. Not the 64802, but the 200-120 to a truck driver. This person has never in his life seen a networking cable or crimper or nothing. Switches, nothing. Blank. Literally from zero. I told him, listen, don't take the boot camp. No, don't take the boot camp. He bought the book. He took the boot camp. It took him 4 months. He got a CCNA. Okay? So it's just how much perseverance do you have? I like listening to this guy. I forget his name all the time. How bad do you want it? That's the question. Some of us need it to maintain our jobs. You know what I mean? Exactly. Some of us need it to maintain our jobs. Some of us need it to get our jobs. Okay? To improve our jobs. So that's just the way it is. Because some of us are, let's say, working help desk, then they don't allow us to go any further than that. We get our CCNA, then they let us move. You know, some people work in very large corporations. So, yeah, perseverance is definitely the key. And you can't give up. I said this last time. I'm saying again, you can't give up. Oh, Lance, I took the test and I failed. What do I do now? Take it again? Okay? Take it again. But it's expensive. I know. So as a person that's going to college for 4 years that paid 60 grand and now he has a loan and he still can't get a job in where he studied. Okay? Because the first 2 years of college are bullshit. The last 2 years are the ones that they actually maybe go into your field. Okay? I'm telling you, I've had people literally graduate from universities, come to the technical college to get their CCNA. And they went to the Cisco Net Academy in their college. How is that possible? Okay. So why you want to go to college and get your bachelor's, just to have a piece of paper so you can put it in there. Hey, I went to college. Awesome. Hey, proud. Go for it, man. All right. But get your damn certification, because that's going to hold more weight than that bachelor's. Okay. You know, I've been having free assessments and I've been asking questions. Oh, I've been asking questions. Okay. And some people, not to humiliate you in any kind of way. Have you tried Vero? No, I haven't tried Vero. I was so pissed off at Vero. Okay. I know you call it Vero. I call it Vero. I was so pissed off at the first version of Vero, updating every 7 days, those salters and Linux. I hate Linux. I was like, you know what? The hell with this freaking simulator. I have not tried Vero 2. Even G, to me so far, has been the best. Okay. GNS3 is good. Just for me, even though when I went to one of my Udemy sessions, David Bumble helped me. And he fixed up my GNS3 for me. You know what I mean? It's like, I don't know. I just don't like that, the handling of Eve, man, it was made for me. Okay. It was made for me. So for CCNA, Packet Tracer, anything above that, you need an emulator. Okay. If you want to go from emulator from the start, why not? If you got the iOSs for the Switch and because it comes already with the VP, the virtual PCs. So if you have the iOS for the Switch and the router already, and you want to start using an emulator now, use it. It can't hurt. All right. It can't hurt. So it doesn't really matter. You're how stuff works. That's all the prior experience. Exactly. Dave's on point. All right. James, does the VNG community work good enough? Yes, of course. Yes. That's the one I use. Yes, it does. Yes, it does. And the community has the community cookbook as well that you want to download. All bunch of information in there. Okay, so definitely. Eve works just fine for me, in my opinion. Okay, Eve NG works just fine. I've tried everything: IPSLAs, MPLS, BGP. Okay, multiple area OSPF. What else? Redistribution. I've done all that stuff in EVNG. You know, me playing with it when I first got it, and it works. And it works just fine. Okay, do they have its glitches? Everything has glitches. My operating system has glitches. I'm using Windows 10. It has glitches. Everything has a glitch. Okay? You can't find a glitch-free anything. Okay? So, just the way it is. Okay? But definitely that's one way to go. All right? These updates keep coming back up. Okay, all right, everybody left. All right, any questions? Any more questions for me? Oh my god, it's been an hour. You guys must be boring. I've been talking your ear off. All right, see you in the boot camp, James. All right, I'll see you then. All right, ladies and gentlemen, if you have nothing else for me, all right, stay safe, take precautions. Now that we're stuck in our homes, turn it into a positive thing. Don't watch Netflix that much. Study. Remember, subscribe to my YouTube. Free videos. Hello. Okay, subscribe to my YouTube. Subscribe to globed.net. So you know, or you took this bootcamp, you already subscribed. So subscribe to globed.net. All right. Join my LinkedIn account, the one with the Panama hat, right? All right. So that way you can send me any message. I'll get it on my phone. Okay. And what else? That's pretty much it, really. Yeah, Glow Better, unless my wife wants to add anything else in there that I forget, because I forget things all the time. All right, it's globed.net, my networking channel, my YouTube channel. I'll have the networking doctor site where you can get the free PDF book. Not free, I'm sorry. It's $4. It's pretty much free. The $4 for the PDF book for IP addressing if you don't have my actual book. But that's it. I just joined lab. How can you use your packet tracer lab? You need to have 7.3. You can download for free from Cisco, from the Cisco Academy. Just go to the Cisco Net Academy or Cisco.com and just search for packet tracer and just download the packet tracer and you can just mimic. That's another thing before I leave. I'm sorry. I said I was going to leave you. I'm sorry. One more thing. When you're looking, now that person asked that question, if you're looking at my videos, okay, they're desktop recordings of the labs, pause it. mimic the lab, and then unpause it, play again. Once I do something, pause it, do it, and then unpause it again, and so forth and so on. I don't want to give it to you. You need to pause it and create it. Create it from scratch, you. So if you have the packet tracer, that's what I'm using for the CCNA, you create it. Pause the damn video and see what I have there and then put it on there, okay? Recreate it, recreate it, all right? I think Mrs. Diaz is putting on the links for the Facebook and all that other stuff, for Twitter and LinkedIn and all that good stuff. It's up anyway, but definitely thank you so much for being here. I appreciate hanging on for an hour and 10 minutes. Oh my God. Thank you so much for being here. Again, she said it, I'm gonna reiterate it, and I said it too. Please be safe, take precautions, all right? Study hard, and hopefully I'll see the majority of you in the boot camp on Saturday. Eastern time. So go to globet.net, subscribe, and see how the boot camp is, all right? I'll see you guys next time. Love you all. Oops. Here, right, end stream. Are you sure you went to end stream? Yes.